Hey everybody, and welcome to another episode of Top Rope TV, the show with all the news and views. I'm your one and only Ken Stryker, and this is a very special Halloween edition, but we're going to break open this episode with breaking news, and that is WWE has released three superstars. Darren Young comes no surprise, as he's been on the injury list for a long time now. Summer Rae, and the shocker that the internet has exploded over is the release of Emma, despite a wonderful looking at the TLC pay-per-view in the debuting Asuka on the main roster. This comes as a major support, but it has also broke out in controversy as new NXT signee Lio Rush made some very controversial statements about it, which left most of the NXT and even Bray Wyatt coming out of the woodwork saying, "You just got here. Why are you saying these things? You have no right to say it." But it's been a rash of controversy all around, and Emma has released a small tweet about what's going on that makes it seem like it was WWE who released her and it wasn't a mutual leaving, and that was a emoji of a heartbroken. So Darren Young, Summer Rae, Emma, as the WWE says, we wish you all the best in your future endeavors. It's looking like the Survivor Series will be another year of bragging rights, as champion versus champion is to be the theme. WWE Hall of Famer and Raw General Manager Kurt Angle announced the entire card on a recent episode of Monday Night Raw. In addition to the Team Raw versus Team SmackDown 5-on-5 traditional Survivor Series match and 5-on-5 Women's Survivor Series match, WWE Universal Champion Brock Lesnar will take on WWE Champion Jinder Mahal. SmackDown Women's Champion Natalya will face Raw Women's Champion Alexa Bliss. The SmackDown Tag Team Champions, the Usos, will go head-to-head with the Raw Tag Team Champions in Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose. And finally, the Intercontinental Champion, The Miz, will face the United States Champion, Baron Corbin. But something tells me that at the 11th hour, one of these titles will change hands. And my money is more on that Baron Corbin will drop the United States Championship before Survivor Series. But either way, it's looking to be like a pretty damn good card for the Survivor Series this year. Speaking of Survivor Series weekend, it's NXT TakeOver time. The night before the Survivor Series, the NXT will put on its greatest showcase that they have. And one thing on the card is actually looking pretty particular, and that will be the return of WWE Hall of Famer, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, as he'll be making an NXT TakeOver appearance where he will challenge NXT's newest big star, Johnny Gargano, to a unique contest, actually. If you didn't know, Shawn Michaels has been working backstage at the NXT of late. He's currently with the NXT Superstars on their recent tour and has been working closely with Johnny Gargano, releasing a series of videos with Johnny wrestling on his Twitter account. The most recent video has Shawn Michaels uploaded was an exciting one. Michaels will take on Gargano instead of one of a dream match for many people, but it will not be a wrestling contest. It has been dubbed "Who Has the Best Abs?" That's right, it's an ab contest. Johnny Gargano will face HBK at NXT TakeOver War Games in an ab off, where it will be decided once and for all who has the best abs, Mr. WrestleMania or Johnny Wrestling. But Shawn Michaels will be involved in NXT the night before, at a special NXT house show where he will be officiating the NXT Championship match between NXT Champion Drew McIntyre and of the Undisputed Era Adam Cole, where the results could have some repercussions for TakeOver. Now, we've all been waiting patiently for Shawn Michaels to return to the ring, but we're finally getting it at an NXT TakeOver. Although it's not in the way we all want, but this does have the potential to make things grow and could lead into something going into WrestleMania season. It seems that R-Truth is suffering from some sort of arm injury. There's no word yet on when the injury happened, but it might have happened during his match at the October 14th WWE live event in Regina, Saskatchewan, when he lost to Elias in singles action. It should be noted that WWE has yet to officially announce his injury or his surgery, but we are told that it will be coming soon. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're coming to that point of the show where we get ready for the Fence Man exclusive. Wait, what are you talking about? It's not the Fence Man exclusive this week? What is that? The El Chupacabra exclusive?
Welcome to the El Chupacabra exclusive here on Top Rope TV. That's right, I took out the Fence Man like I took out everybody else that goes in my way with this, and I will own this show as I, El Chupacabra, take over Top Rope TV and take over the world. But tonight is the next El Chupacabra exclusive. It is a match featuring Chris Banks versus God knows who, but in Warriors of Wrestling action. So stay tuned in the first of many El Chupacabra exclusives as I take over the world. Yeah! Woo!
Darius Carter came out here and said that I was injured, so I hope he gets it right. It's not too obvious either. Unfortunately, I won't be in a tag match tonight against the Hostile, whatever they are. But, because of contracts, I have to oblige, I will be defending my No Limits Championship right here, right now, in a triple threat. So let's make it happen. Let's find out who's qualified.
Yeah!
Over my segment on Top Row TV. You're done. Fuck you, you motherfucker. Cut.
Yo, this is the Fence Man here. Now that I took back my segment, the Fence Man exclusive is rightfully back to me. Now, without further ado, our next match will be another Chris Banks match where he competes in this time CCW action. So, without further ado, Chris Banks in CCW action here on Top Rope TV. Now that I got my segment back from that monster El Chupacabra, and he's been squashed for good. Peace.
His way to the ring, the challenger. He hails from Cockeysville, Maryland, weighing 190 pounds, Bro Keller.
Hey, Chris Banks! Let's go, Bob. Here we go.
Free the belt, Stephen.
Hey,
hey, Ginger. That's not the way you go to the ring.
Oh,
come on, Aubrey, give me the count.
One, two.
Oh, he must have been five.
Yeah.
You know, I'm all down for Halloween and everything, but that was a little on the weird side, even for the Fenceman exclusive, which seems to have taken over once again. Thank you, Alan, and we'll see you on next week's episode. But let's get back to some news and views, and this is another shocker. As Jeff Jarrett has checked into rehab to battle his alcohol addiction, according to reports. Jarrett was fired earlier this week from his executive position at Impact Wrestling. Now, his wife, Karen, has worked with WWE officials in setting up, as Jeff is a former WWE superstar and therefore is eligible for the WWE-sponsored rehab program that has helped many superstars with their own addictions. Ricochet is no longer taking any bookings until the end of January. According to recent reports, Ricochet is no longer under contract with New Japan Pro Wrestling or Lucha Underground. Ricochet has openly expressed interest in going to the WWE in the past. There are rumors that he might be ready to join the company. Ricochet is also the reigning PWG World Champion after defeating Chuck Taylor during night 2 of PWG's All-Star Weekend. It's worth noting that PWG hasn't announced any dates for upcoming events. ACH has replaced Ricochet as part of the tag team for the Super Junior Tag Team Tournament in Japan. So, we're waiting on word. It's not clear, but hopefully we will see him as part of the cruiserweight division in WWE shortly. Former UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion Ronda Rousey has been training at the WWE Performance Center in Orlando, Florida this week. Rousey, along with a few others, have been going on pro wrestling training the last few weeks. Now, Shayna Baszler has recently signed with the WWE and will be placed in NXT. It is expected that WWE will have Rousey wrestle a match at WrestleMania 33 against either Charlotte Flair or Stephanie McMahon. Either way, it's a celebrity Hall of Fame induction waiting to happen. Combat Zone Wrestling announced on their official Twitter that Jimmy Jacobs, former WWE producer, will be returning to the company at their Night of Infamy event on Saturday night, November 11th. Now, Jimmy Jacobs is no longer employed by WWE. The infamous Bullet Club invasion of Raw a few weeks ago was cited as the possible straw that broke the camel's back. There was a lot of heat on him for posting an Instagram photo of himself with Bullet Club members during the invasion at the Raw TV event in Ontario, California. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the Top Rope Wrestling Flashback. And I picked a good one for Halloween this year. And that one is El Guerrero teaming with the Joker to take on Father Deadpool and the one and only Spider-Man.
And the Joker is the special referee.
Oh boy.
Okay? This match is a 15-minute time limit, okay?
15.
God knows what's going to happen. I've never had superheroes on a wrestling show before, okay? Especially Marvel superheroes.
Marvel.
So, let's bring out our first Marvel superhero. And
here comes a Spider-Man.
Being led to the ring by Catwoman. He hails from your neighborhood. He is your friendly webhead. Spider-Man!
What's up, man?
In the chill of night, at the scene of a crime, like a streak of light, he arrives just in time. Spider-Man, Spider-Man, friendly neighborhood Spider-Man.
Oh, look at this.
He's ignored. Action is his reward to him. Life is a great big day.
I gotta admit, Catwoman. And Spider-Man's opponent. Ladies and gentlemen, being led to the ring by Harley Quinn, I give to you Deadpool 3. Well, once again, let's give it up for these guys who came to do this. Spider-Man!
Deadpool rocks!
Deadpool Priest! Harley Quinn!
Never mind.
And Catwoman. And now, Tigga, listen, Tigga, before we get to this match, you're not the referee. So, Tigga,
what's
Harley,
see ya.
Guys,
bye-bye.
Huh? So, I did book this match. These guys got a hold of me from the Marvel Universe. I said Marvel. And I want to thank Marvel for getting a hold of me. And so
We're going to have, we got to get our special guest referee out here.
Yeah, we need one.
So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to get my lazy ass up and go in the back and pull the Joker by the head of his hair and get him out here.
I got this. Don't worry about it. I got this. Go do what you got to do.
Yeah, man.
Catwoman is looking so lovely tonight. And Deadpool, you are the man. Wait a minute. Here we go. Here's the Joker.
Sweet tea.
What the?
Sweet tea.
Wait.
Get in the ring.
The guy in the green hair. Look.
Get in the ring, sweet tea.
Oh, hey.
There he is.
The Joker's here.
Ladies and gentlemen, your special guest referee, the Joker. Joker.
Now we're talking.
What's Joker doing?
Right? Taking his shirt off.
Sweet tea.
He just stole Tiggy's shirt.
Yep. Yep. Wow.
Harley cheated on you?
With that?
Wow. What? So, Joker, whenever you're ready, we'll ring the bell. What? He's been eating a lot of Philly cheesesteaks.
Blame Wawa.
He's been here. Listen, Spider-Man's been here for about 2 weeks during the Comic-Con
thing. And Catwoman got that.
And Spider-Man's been eating a lot of Philly cheesesteaks.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, look at this guy. Look at the Joker.
Right. Joker's getting ready.
Yeah, you pay.
Joker, shall I ring the bell? Oh, you got to check them?
Just for the record, I left you because you're not a real man.
What did she just say?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I like the Joker. I like the Joker. He's got class and he's got style, the Joker. So does Deadpool.
I'm going to let you guys do this one.
All right, here we go. I don't know what kind of moves you're going to do, but I'm going to try to call it.
Joker just hanging around.
All right, Rat Boy. Is he just laying down?
What's going on?
What's going on here? What?
11.
Mark it. 1, 2. Oh, kick up by Deadpool.
Oh.
Almost 2 count, but it wasn't there for Spidey. Here we go again.
What's going on here? What is the Joker doing to Spider-Man?
Okay. 2. Kick. Oh, another kick out by Deadpool. Now Spider-Man's laying down. Now Deadpool's praying. This is interesting.
It's your match, ain't
it? Here we go. Is the referee going to make... Oh, kicked up by Spider-Man. What the hell is going on here? Who's coming out? What's going on?
What's going on?
Hey, Joker, don't go. What's he doing out here?
What's he doing out here?
What are you doing out here? He's not a superhero. What's going on?
Hey. Cut his music.
Okay.
Wait. Hey. Hey.
What's going on?
Hey. Hey, you know, you're starting to piss me off a real lot lately, okay? I just got up to take a break, because, you know, once in a while I have to take a break. I've got these guys here for the kids, and you're going to come out here and just ruin it? What's your problem?
You want to know what's my problem? My problem is the last week on Friday, I lost the local World Heavyweight belt, tag team belt. And you know why? Because two cheers, I lost the belt. But you know what? I don't care. I want a tag match tonight. I don't have my tag team partner here, but I don't care. I face this too. I don't know what you are, like little Spider-Man and the Soul Fat Deadpool, something like that. Anyway, make this match happen right now because I don't care that I don't have my partner tonight.
All right, hold on. Let me talk to the people. Can I talk to the people? Give me a second.
Hey. We have a tag match here? What's going on?
Guys, you guys. Psst, hey, can you guys go over there for a second? I gotta talk to the people. Hey, I gotta talk to the people. Do you guys understand anything this fool said?
No!
I mean, cause usually in my back pocket, I usually have a book that's Spanish for Dummies, but I forgot it tonight. So, I didn't understand. All I understood was match, wrestle, Marvel superheroes, no partner, and I get to talk to the people. You guys want to see these two guys?
Yeah.
Beat up this guy?
Yeah.
So again, ladies, would you want to see these two guys beat up this guy? Just say yes. Puddin'?
Yes, Puddin'.
I like her. So again, it's up to you guys. I do this for you guys. You guys want to see Deadpool and Spider-Man beat up on El Guerrero? What? Hey, with or without a partner, you asked for this. So now it's Team Marvel versus you. Team you. You don't have a partner.
I can't do it by myself.
But you're not the people.
I can't do it by myself.
You can't do it by yourself?
I
have an idea. I have an idea. Spider-Man, sit down. Web Slinger, chill out. I got you a partner.
No.
Yeah, I'm gonna get you a partner. Joker?
Yeah.
Joker? Joker?
I don't want no partner. I can't do it by myself.
Joker. You know, I just paid the electric bill. All right, well, you know what? I guess we're going to wrestle in the dark. I thought we paid the bill. That's okay. You guys ready? Two on one? He's like, I don't need a partner. I don't know Spanish, but you're on your own. Where the hell did you come from? The lights go out, they come back on, and Joker's sitting in the corner. Hey, Beans, you want to be funny? You want to be funny? Get up on the side of the apron. You now have a tag team partner. You have a... Hey. Hey. All right. So it's Joker and El Guerrero, the Joker Express, against Team Marvel. Viper Dalton, ring the bell.
Come on, let him tag up with him. Come on. What is he talking about? Do you understand a word he's saying?
No,
because I sure as hell don't.
He speaks Spanish.
Oh, well, hey. I only speak English.
Me's Americano.
Did you say barracudas in underwear? I don't know.
I'm Americano.
I don't know. Who wants you anyway?
Holly.
Who can be like Ric Flair?
Oh.
Oh.
You know what? I don't blame the Joker for leaving her. I wouldn't want her either. Catwoman, however. Anyway, back to the match. Here we go. Yeah. Suplex.
Oh! What a
suplex
shame.
By El Guerrero on Deadpool. Almost. Oh! Deadpool kicks out. Almost a two count. Almost a three count, but not even there. Trying to make the tag into Spidey.
Oh, trying to tag his partner, but.
Oh! That was a nice elbow drop by El Guerrero.
Oh, leg
drop!
Oh!
Hulk Hogan. Oh!
Two count,
but not even there.
Oh, Spider-Man's in.
Tags into the web slinger.
Trying to spin his web
now. See what Spidey's got. Test of strength by El Guerrero and Spider-Man.
There goes one. Come on, lock up.
I don't understand. What are you seeing her, Joker? I gotta know. Test of strength again. Oh. What's going on here? Oh,
test of strength.
Spider-Man. They're going crazy for Spider-Man. Oh my God!
Here we go.
Whips him into the corner. Oh! Oh. Clothesline. Aguero's down. Oh, two count only. Going for another pin.
Spider-Man got two again.
Another two count. Looks like he's got him in the head scissors. Looks like he's going down.
Oh, Spider-Man.
Two count. Tags in the Deadpool. Looks like El Guerrero, man. Trying to make it into the corner. What's this? The Joker wasn't even there.
God, the Joker put around with him.
Deadpool is taking it to El Guerrero with oh, clothesline by Deadpool. Russian leg sweep by Deadpool. Oh, two count, but not even there.
He's going to do a flip. Come on, Deadpool.
Oh, here we go. Oh, two count. Forearm smashes it. El Guerrero by Deadpool.
Count with Deadpool.
Now he's riding him like a horse, baby.
Woo!
Yeah! Here comes Spider-Man. Oh! Sticking the boots to El Guerrero. Is this a sleeper hold?
Spider-Man got him.
Rear naked choke?
Is there a tap?
The rear Spidey choke?
There's no tap. Look at that.
Well, it looks like he didn't tap at all. It looks like El Guerrero's got him now. Clothesline!
I think Spider-Man hurt.
Spider-Man is... He's down. Looks like the fans are chanting for Spider-Man.
Here
comes
Joker.
Deadpool.
Joker is
taking his big butt to the Joker. The Joker is now in the ring. Let's see what's going to happen here, folks.
Let's see what the Joker's got up his sleeve. Man, he don't got no sleeve.
Funny, don't you? You don't impress me. Just call the match.
I hate you, Joker.
Shake his hand. I was tricking a book, and Deadpool fell for it. Oh, well. Two count.
Come on, get up on your feet. Come on. You know. I'm back. They both got shocked. Just have a seat, Chris.
Oh,
Marsh.
Two count. Nope. What the heck is going on with Spider-Man?
Joker's choking him.
Spider spasms?
Choking
him. Uh-oh. Like Harley Quinn was trying to come over here. What was she up to? Hey, it's Super Boricua.
Uh-oh.
Wow. Is he gonna fly? Oh my God! Oh. It was a spear by El Guerrero on Spider-Man. Oh, Deadpool makes the save.
Look at this. X is arguing.
Love world.
Harley Quinn arguing with the Joker.
Catwoman interfered. Spider-Man, Deadpool, I won it. Spider-Man and Deadpool
are playing! The winners of the match! Spider-Man! Deadpool! Team Marvel!
Can't you see? Just like guys, look out! Here comes the Spider-Man! Is he strong? Listen, bud! He's got radioactive blood! Can he swing from a thread? Take a look overhead! Hey, man!
Hey, you guys, Team Marvel, hold it,
and what a great match that was right there for the Top Rope Wrestling Flashback. Whew, Spider-Man and Father Deadpool picking up the victory, but we got to go to one more segment. And it's the segment that has been said to make you think. It is the segment that makes you ponder the ponderless. It is a wonderful little segment we call the Short Segment with Ian Short. Take it away, Ian. It just makes you think. It just makes you wonder the deepest wonders of the universe. But that is one way we'll end this week's edition of Top Rope TV. But we got to send out a very special congratulations to Crazy Mary Dobson, who is wrestling in NXT as Sarah Logan, as she has gotten engaged. So congratulations to you, Mary, Sarah, former Top Rope Radio mainstay, especially on the 30 Minutes with Big Jim segment. But until next time, keep your wrestling in a headlock, and we'll see you next time right here on Top Rope TV.